All right, awesome. Now we have the Sapphire Radeon RX 5700 8GB card. Awesome. How do you get it in your machine? Well, don't worry, guys. I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. Whoa, hold on. So, before we get started, go ahead and click like and subscribe and the little bell notification. That way you guys get notified the next time I come out with a video like this, showing you guys how to install a video card, a CPU, a motherboard, RAM, playing the latest game, and then all those other new gadgets that come out. All right guys, so in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to upgrade your PC with the latest and greatest Sapphire Pulse Radeon RX 5700 8GB OC with the backplate. This again is the PCIe by 4 card, but that is also backwards compatible with 2 and 3, so you're good pretty much anything you have. This is again to show you how to update, so no matter what video card you have. In my particular system, I have the EVGA GeForce RTX 2080 XT Ultra card. Now, it could be better, it could be worse. Again, it doesn't matter, I'm just showing you guys how to install it. If you already have a card in your machine, I'm gonna show you real quick how to remove it. You don't just yank it out. And then after that, I'll show you how to install it. So come over here real quick. Okay, so now, even before you touch that video card or anything inside of the system, you're going to want to ground yourself. Now you could use a wrist strap connected to the case or some ground, or easily you can just touch like the case. That's gonna go ahead and discharge any of the ESD you have in your hands. Okay, then also what we're going to want to do before we do anything else is unplug the PCIe cables. Okay, that's again, if you have a card, and just in case, you don't want to, you can't just pull them out. Just gonna have to push that down, and that's gonna unlatch the card and then pull it out. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead and unscrew the card. Okay, now we can't simply just pull the card out because then we'll actually rip out the PCIe slot. So there's a little notch right over here, and let me zoom in so you can see it. Okay, and it might be a little hard to see, but it's right down there. So what you need to do is push that in. Okay, and that releases the card. So I'm gonna zoom out so that you can actually see the card move up a little bit after I push it. So I'm gonna push it back in and you're gonna see that pop back up. Okay, you saw that just move up. So let me zoom back out. Okay, so again, I'm gonna push this in. You're gonna see the card come out a little tiny bit. Okay. You saw the card just go just a little tiny bit. And now I can easily just pull the card up, and there we go. So now we took out our old card. Now we're gonna go ahead and put in our new card. So here's the card. Now we're just gonna go ahead and align it. We can do it easily right through here, through the PCIe slot cover. And we can just leave these in, the dust covers over here. That'll help guide us, so we can just move that out of the way. Okay, so then you'll notice these fingers here, aside from lining it up with the PCIe slot over here, you're going to want to line those fingers up with this slot right here. So we'll just put that right here. Okay, you see how that lines up perfectly? And then that card just snaps into place. And if you notice, that little notch that I pushed in to pull the other card out just clicked right back out. And then before you end up screwing in the card, you're going to want to make sure that you can pull these out. Last thing you want to do is screw it in and then these things be stuck behind this over here. That way you can actually use your video card. Okay, now with the card in, just gonna go ahead and screw it into place. Now because of the improved cooling this card has and the heat pipes and all that good stuff, this card sticks out a little bit, so makes it a little bit harder to get back over here. Not impossible, just a little bit more difficult. If your previous card took up three slots like mine did, just want to make sure you have another cover laying around. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that back in place. Now, leaving that bare is not going to mess up anything. It's just going to help keep a little dust out of the system. Keep your pressure, be it positive or negative pressure. And now we're going to go ahead and, if you remember, we removed the PCIe cables. We're just going to go ahead and pop those back in. Now, since this is a little bit different, AMD has the notches on the top, whereas NVIDIA had them on the bottom. So I pushed down here. Now I'm going to have to push up here. And then, of course, I'm going to have to flip these around a little tiny bit. And I'll pretty up the cabling a little bit later on. All right, and that's it. You've officially updated your computer, at least with the latest and greatest video card. Now, the next thing you need to do is install the drivers. And of course, before that, you're going to need to remove your older driver. So I'm gonna go ahead and link up above a video on how to remove the drivers. Iggy out. See you guys.